welcome to Full Frontal. You know, sometimes I tease the president, but tonight I want to salute him for keeping a campaign promise.
We're going to cancel the Paris Climate Agreement.
Oh, no, that was a campaign threat. Last night, for 5 blessed hours, Donald J. Trump made America truly great.
Kafif, Kafefi.
Kofefe, Kofefe.
Kofefe, how do you say it?
Kofefi.
Kofefi or Kofefe?
Kofefe.
Kofefe.
Kofefe. Trump is right. He really does have the best words. And he spelled it right. V before E, except after Z. The Twitterverse greeted Kofefe's arrival with unfettered rapture. For that glorious interlude between midnight and 5 a.m., we were like passengers on the Titanic who decided to say, "F it," and rock out to the band. Thank you. We are Kofefe. We'll all be dead real soon. This is what happens when you've abstained from your phone for 9 days. You ejaculate just like that. Kofefe! Oh yeah, did I mention POTUS had been away? Trump staff worked hard preparing him for his first foreign trip, though the purpose of going to Saudi Arabia wasn't clear to everyone.
Ace! Go.
What's going on?
Head Nace.
Why?
I don't know. That's the order.
But Trump couldn't wait to get to the desert. Steve Bannon went along for the ride. So did the ubiquitous Jared Kushner.
I just promoted myself.
And of course, Trump brought Stephen Miller to write his speeches.
I am the scales of justice, conductor of the choir of death.
Toby Keith performed an awesome set. And we sold the Saudis an ass ton of weapons. Sorry, Yemen. POTUS then tootled off to Europe for some actual fury.
While they all walked in a group to take a photo, Trump chose instead to ride alone in a golf cart.
I am starting to think that Venice Beach hobo you call a doctor didn't give you a proper physical. That poor laboring golf cart was the least welcome vehicle in Europe since Soviet tanks rolled into Hungary. And if you don't want the media fixating on your lack of stamina, give them something else to talk about. You can't just fly to Europe and shun the press. You're not Greta Garbo. We wouldn't gorge on candy if you'd give us some meat. How about answering questions about the jackass driving this administration's proverbial golf cart into the ditch? Precocious slumlord and part-time death mask model, Jared Kushner.
Mr. President, did Jared try to set up a back channel to the Russians?
Oh my God, 5? 5 back channels? You thought Ivanka's last book was bad? Just wait till Jared goes to jail. Her next book is gonna be fire. In a trash can. It's gonna be a trash can fire.
Single parenting while your husband is in prison. This is a big problem women are dealing with for the very first time. Here are some quotes from Black Lives Matter activists that I've misquoted to make them about me. Architecting.
As Winnie Mandela once said, oh, thank you, thank you. As Winnie Mandela once said, who needs a husband when you have champagne popsicles? Hashtag roar. Now look, we can't assume Jared knowingly broke the law. It's possible that the Russians planted this story to screw with us. It's also possible that the person POTUS trusts with negotiating Mideast peace, reforming the criminal justice system, solving the opioid epidemic, advising the commander-in-chief, and reinventing the entire government is just a complete f***ing idiot. How comforting.
What manner of ignorance, chaos, hubris, suspicion, contempt would you have to have?
Ignorance, chaos, hubris, suspicion, and contempt, or as they're also known, Trump's senior staff. That's why POTUS... That's why POTUS has engaged outside lawyers who are ruining his life. They want to start vetting his tweets. So some lucky schmuck will get paid $1,500 an hour to evaluate whether White Pride Ballsack 6969 is a reliable source for the president to retweet. They even got Trump to cancel a rally in Iowa, which is like Cookie Monster going on a diet. It might be better for you, but it's not what you're about, man. He cannot live like this. Trump without screaming flaming mobs and Twitter bots is like Tinkerbell without clapping. He'll flutter to the ground and wink out. Oh no, there he goes. There he goes. Believe, boys and girls. Believe he's the victim of a hashtag witch hunt. Oh, it is a dark time for this president, but perhaps he can cast his gaze upon that bust of Winston Churchill and draw inspiration from the great leader's example of partnering with Russia to defeat Germany. We'll be right back.